And I'll follow. Oh, they just can't face. Some folks, they spend their whole lives just trying to keep it. They carry it with them every step that they take. I grew up in this little town, and as I got older, I started looking around me, and it didn't seem like there was any way that I was gonna get out of there. As I look back at my father, and the only time he'd ever gotten out of that town was to go to World War II. And then when he came out of the army, he got married. And he settled down. He went to work in a plastics factory. And his father had done the same thing. And it seemed that the one thing that we had in common was that we didn't have enough information. We didn't have enough knowledge about the things and the forces that were controlling our lives. And I watched my old man end up a victim, and he didn't even know it. And he didn't even know of what. Now, back in the 60s then, people were asking a lot of questions about those kinds of things. But the only place that I ever heard it was that here at night when I was listening to the radio. I'd lay up in bed with the radio underneath my pillow. And at the time it was just so much great stuff on. And it seemed like in those songs by the Drifters, and in those songs like by Smokey Robinson, there was the promise. And it was just a promise of a right to a decent life. That you didn't have to live and die like my old man did, working in some factory till he couldn't hear what you were saying to him anymore. And when I go back, I see there's friends of mine that when we were young, they were strong and they were tough inside. They had strong hearts, and they had dreams. And slowly, these days, that stuff gets beat. It gets beat out of you, and you get run down, and you get weary, and you get tired. And the only thing that kept, when I was young, kicked me from giving up, was that in the rock and roll music that I heard, there was a promise that there was a meaning in life, a meaning in living. But it's a promise that gets easy broken today. And there's nobody but yourself, I guess, that can make that promise come true. And it's been broken too many times. So you gotta stay hard inside. Well, Papa, go to bed now, 'cause it's getting late. And nothing we can say can change anything now. 'Cause I'll be leaving in the morning from St. Mary's Gate. It wouldn't change this thing, even if we could somehow. 'Cause the darkness in this house has got the best of us. And there's a darkness in this town that's got us too. But they can't touch me. And you can't touch me now. And they ain't gonna do to me what I watched them do to you. This time. breaker's point. Well, there's a lot of people leaving town now, leaving their friends and their homes. At night they walk the dark and dusty highway all alone. Well, Papa, go to bed now, 'cause it's getting late, and nothing we can say can change anything now, because there's just different people coming down here now, and they see things in different ways, and soon everything we know will just be swept away.
Memphis, Tennessee. And I went down. It was late at night, it was 3 a.m. And me and Steve, we got in a taxi cab and we went down to Elvis Presley's house. And we stood outside the gates. And the gates were all locked up. But there was one little light on in the window. And I said, Steve, I bet that's his bedroom. I bet she's in there a week right now. So we had the taxi cab driver with us. And no, don't climb over that wall because they got big dogs over there. And they'll eat you up and everything. So I climbed up over the wall. And I jumped. I jumped down on the other side. I was ready for it to be attacked. But nothing happened, so I ran up the driveway and I stood in front of the front door. And as I was about to knock, this guard came out of the woods and said, "What do you want?" I said, "Is Elvis home?" And he said, "No, he's not home. He's in Lake Tahoe." So I said, "Oh, well, can you tell him that I was here?" Yo, I said, "I got a band and we just played in town tonight and I have some records that we made." And he said, sure. And he said, "You gotta get out now." So he walked me down and they unlocked the front gate and we walked out. I felt pretty good about it, even though I didn't get to see it. But, it wasn't too long after that he died. And that summer, I just started listening to all his old records again and a lot of the new things. And I used to think a lot, and I used to wonder how it was that somebody that seemed like such a big winner could lose so bad in the end, you know? And because he deserved a lot better than what he got. And but this song is about living free. It's about not having to die poor after working in some factory, or it's about not having to die in some million-dollar mansion with a whole lot of dope running through you. It's about feeling yourself strong inside, no matter who you are. Well, once I rode that ribbon highway, I saw above me the endless sky. I saw below me a golden valley. Well, this land was big for you and dust clouds rolling.
the bells were ringing and the fog was lifting, and I heard this land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is mine. door slams. Mary's just sleeps. Like a vision, she dances across the porch as the radio plays. Roy Orbison singing for the lonely. Hey, that's me, and I want you only. Don't turn me on again. I just can't face myself alone again. Don't you run back inside. You know just what I'm here for. So you're scared and you think that maybe we ain't that young. But that's all right with me.
Ah!
driving in my car. I turn on the radio. I'm pulling you close. You just say no. You say you don't like it. Oh, girl, I know you're lying. 'Cause when we kiss,
this is a song that some close friends of mine got married while we were making the River album. And we went out to the wedding. And the rabbi got up and he gave a sermon about how one person can have a dream, but it takes two to make a dream come true. That's a simple thing, I guess, you know? But it's what you try to do when you go out with your friends, or I guess it's what we're trying to do here tonight with you. And some people turn away from that simple thing. And it's like a song, if you write a song, it's no good and it doesn't have any meaning until somebody hears it. So I hear you too. Some people don't get to make that connection. This is a song about that. I need a little quiet for this song. Thank you. Thank you.
play.
Is the song. This is from Darkness on the Edge of Town. This is called Racing in the Street.
Tonight, the highway's bright out of my way.
summer's here and the time is bright. I'm going racing in the street.
cutting on the big streets, 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 cutting on the big streets.
Stockholm. One, two.
Suicide machines. Smoke cages on the highway and pouring through shadows.
a honey, it's a lover boy, me, that's a knocking. You better get a witness to the river, everybody's at the high school, Bobby. Put on your rocking shoes, the jukebox blowing fuse. Well, everybody's hopping, everybody's hopping. Coming on the ground. Come on, let's go.
I want to thank everybody for coming down to the show tonight. Thank you. I know a lot of you guys waited in line for a long time for your tickets, and I want you to know that we appreciate it. Thanks for giving us such a warm welcome to Stockholm.
Thank you.